Hi, welcome to the series of tutorials for the Golden Age Testnet. In this video, we are going to go over the new Golden Age version of the Pelagus wallet. This is the most feature-complete testnet to date that we've had. And as a reminder, this is going to be the last testnet before mainnet. Let's get straight into it and check out the new features. And also, as a kind of a note, this is the main wallet for the Golden Age testnet, and it is the only wallet that supports both QI and QUAI. We click on download and add it to your browser. You have to have a Chromium-based browser. If something is not working, I would suggest using Google Chrome. However, things work for me in Brave as well, so I'll use Brave in this video. Once you download the extension, you get a pretty familiar screen where you can either use an existing wallet or create a new wallet. If you want to use an existing wallet, you can either import it using a recovery phrase, or you can use a private key, or you can also import read-only addresses. In this video, we are going to create a new wallet, and here you will have to create a password, which is pretty regular. For the smoothest experience, I would recommend to set Pelagus as your default wallet. If you don't want to have Pelagus as your default wallet on your main account, you can also create a separate profile in your browser by clicking here onto the right tab. Usually there are you can create a bunch of profiles there. Anchors away and let's go. So once you get this warning that you have to be very careful and not show your secret recovery phrase to anybody, I'm going to show you mine. So here are the 24 words. You can copy the phrase to clipboard, or ideally you write it down on a piece of paper and hide it somewhere safe. And also I would recommend you to still keep the private keys in the future as well. So copy the phrase to clipboard and you just go through the process as you usually do. Once you verify the recovery phrase, you can finalize the creation of your wallet and you are good to go. In order to see your Pelagus in the extensions list, you can pin this like this and there you go. And welcome to the Pelagus alpha version. This is just the beginning of the testnet. I suspect that there could be some changes to this version, but there shouldn't be any major updates that will make this tutorial irrelevant. Once you open up the wallet, you are welcomed with this QUAI page. So because there are two tokens in the QUAI ecosystem, QUAI token and a QI token, there are two different ledgers. QUAI token has an account-based ledger that is like Ethereum, and QI has a UTXO-based ledger that is like Bitcoin. We are welcomed with a QUAI account, so you see that I have 0 QUAI on this wallet because I just created it. Here you can check what network you are on. You can also choose to show developer environments such as the local or the Orchard environments. There are different ones you can set up, and Orchard is the one that we have in the QUAI office for testing. And here you can check out your addresses. So Cypress One is the only shard that is going to be running during the Golden Age testnet, because single shard can process about 500 transactions per second. So until you get above that, you're only going to need your Cypress One address. So Cypress One address for QUAI wallet. You can also copy your address here for quick access by clicking on this button, which basically the typical copy button. Send receive is everything as usual. You can also add a custom asset by pasting a contract address. So if you deployed some meme coin or any other token on QUAI network, you can use the contract address, paste it here and add it, and it should be all active and you'll be able to see it here. You can also see your past history of transactions, and you can also clean this history in the future. So here, if you click on this little arrow down, you see that we are in the QUAI account. And once you switch to the QI wallet, you see that I also have a Cypress One QI wallet. I click on this wallet and I get to my QI address. If there is anything important in this video, is that this QI address is not your mining address. This is your payment code that you can use to ask people to send you money, but you cannot use it to mine. If you would like to mine QI, which you can do, you have to go to the settings by clicking on these three lines, and here you see the QI mining addresses. And here you can generate your mining addresses to if you are a miner. So right now we only have Cypress 1, as I already mentioned, and that's the only one you can generate your mine. Click confirm and you generate an EVM login address here. You see that it looks like 0x00 la la la, and you can copy it here and use this during your mining setup. Let's quickly go over the other settings that are pretty self-explanatory and pretty basic, as other wallets have them. You can report a bug, and if you need help, you can also contact our support. There are custom QUAI assets, which you can also add from the wallet without the settings. You can turn off the notifications. You can also turn off the setting to have Pelagus as your default wallet and see what websites you have connected Pelagus to. You can also check out Discord, Twitter, and GitHub. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments, or again, reach out to support or go to our Discord. We'll be happy to help you. Thank you for watching and see you in the next tutorials.